Hello students, how are you? I hope you all will be fine. Today we'll start our third chapter, decimals. Okay, in the decimals, we have done this in previous class, your sixth class. Okay, so this exercise is very basic, means depend on your sixth class. So here we will do only ascending, descending, conversion into simplest form, in the mixed form, and like decimals, unlike decimals. And some conversion also, like convert rupees, paisas in rupees and rupees in paisa, meter in kilometer, like that. Okay, so we'll start with our first sum, that is convert each of the following into a fraction in its simplest form. Okay, so what is given? First part, 0.8 is given. Okay, 0.8. We have to convert this into fraction. Fraction means in the form of the numerator and the denominator. Okay, in its simplest form. Also simplest. Simplest means if they are cutting on any common table, we will cut that and our answer will be very, very simplest form or very easy form. So first, this is decimal. This is decimal. We have to convert this into fraction. Fraction means numerator upon denominator. So 0.8, remove this point. First we will remove the decimal point. That means 8 upon 10. Okay. Now what we have to do, simple fraction is this now, okay, but in the simplest form. If they are cutting, so both are divisible by 2. Yes, so 2 4s are and 2 5s are. So now 4 and 5 not going on any other table. That means 0.8 is in decimal form and in simplest form is equal to 4 upon 5. Now I'm doing the third part of this. I think this is third part. 0.06. Point similarly, first we will convert into fraction. Fraction means numerator, denominator. So we don't want this in decimal. So we will remove the decimal point. This is your decimal point. 0.06. After decimal, how many digits? 2 digits? 1, 2. So that means 1, 2. Like this? Yes. Means if there is 1 digit after decimal, we will divide by 10. If there is 2 digit, there is 2 digits. 1, 2. So we will put 2 zeros and 1. Okay, means 100. So now, if they are cutting, cut that. Both are not cutting on the table of 6. So we will cut that on the table of 2. 2 threes are, 2 fives are and 0. Now, 3 upon 50 is in simplest form and is also in fraction. Okay. Question number 2. Convert as a mixed fraction. Means convert in the mixed fraction. When we will convert in mixed fraction, first we will convert that into fraction. And after that we will convert that into mixed. Okay. So here is second part. 12.25. First we will convert this into fraction, then in mix. So to convert into fraction, we don't need this decimal. So remove this decimal. Here will be 100. Now here will be 100. Now cut that. They are cutting at the table of 5. 5 twos are and 0. 5 twos are 10. 5 fours are 20. Then 5 5s are 25. Again going on 5. So cut that. 2 4 5 divided by 20. 5 4s are 20 and 5 9s are. What we are having here? 49 upon 4. Okay. So now what we will do? What we will do here? We will divide this 49 by 4, like this. Okay, 4 1 ja minus, here will be 9, 4 2 ja 8, here will be 1. Here we will not try for the 0 remainder. Okay, because we don't need in decimal, we need in mixed fraction. So what is our answer? 12 whole 1 upon 4. This is our answer. So here will be 12 whole 1 upon 4. Okay. And one more way is there to do this, to this sum. One more method is there. How to do that? Suppose your number is given. Your number is 12.25. Okay. So this is our whole part and this is our decimal part. Okay. So whole part will be, we can write this number as 12 whole separate and this 0.25 separate. Okay. 12 will be as it is. 25, remove the decimal. Here will be 100. 1 and 4. So what we will get? Now combine this 12 plus 1 upon 4. That means 12 whole 1 upon 4. Look at here. Both answers are same. But methods are different. Methods are different. Either you can use this or that. Okay. Both. I think this is the simplest one. Okay. This is the simplest one. Whatever is suitable for you, you can use that one. Okay. Now the another part of this, question number 2. Question number 2, another part is fourth part, 4.625. So I'll use the second method here. I'll use here second method. Okay. 4 is the whole part, take that separate, plus 0.625. Now 4 plus, remove this decimal. If I have to remove this, how many digit? 1, 2, 3 and 1. Okay. So now this and this is cutting on 25. Okay. 25 4 the 0. 25 25. Okay, so now again cutting on 5, 5, 5 is 5, 8. So what do you get here? 5 upon 8. But we cannot write numerator big in a mixed fraction. Means if you will compare this, we cannot write. So, okay. So what it will be? 4 whole 5 upon 8 by the another method. If we will use that method, okay, 4.625 and divided by 1000 means this method. So it will be very lengthy for you to cut this. It will be very lengthy. So that's why I use here this method. Okay. So you can use this method. This is very easy. Okay. Now the next question is question number 3. In the question number 3, I have taken 3 part here. Okay. What we have to do in that? Please read the statement. In the question number 3, we have to convert into decimals. Now, means our statement will not be in decimals. We have to convert that into decimal. When we are talking about the decimal, that means we are talking about the decimal point. Okay. So, here we have to convert into decimals. So, we will put the decimal point. Okay. So, take any part. First, third part I am taking here. That is 2516 divided by 100. Okay. We know that division by 10,000 is very easy. Okay. We can directly put the decimal point by counting the zeros. So how many zeros are there? 2. Okay. So our point will be 2516. 1, 2. So point will be here. So this is a decimal. This is a decimal. Simple. Okay. Next is fourth part. 3 whole 2 upon 5. We need our answer in decimal. This is a mixed fraction. So first we will convert this into fraction, improper fraction. Then in decimal. So convert that. 5 3 is a 15 plus 2 17 upon 5. Okay. 17 upon 5. वन वे टू डू दिस, यू कैन डिवाइड दिस, यू कैन डिवाइड 17/5, यू कैन डिवाइड 17/5. Another way you can think about a number when you will multiply the denominator by that number, you can get 10, 100, 1000, means anything from that. So if I multiply 5 by 2, what I will get? 10. So if I'm multiplying the denominator, I have to also multiply numerator. So 17 to the 34. Okay, now there is 10. It is very simple. When denominator is 10, 100, and 1000, to put a decimal point, there is 10. So 3.4. One way is this. Okay. Another way, what you will do? You will divide 17/5. Means you are having this. So how you will put first 5 threes are 15. Then you will get here 2. Then it's not going. So decimal point. And you put 10, 4, 5, 4, 20. Another way is this. This is also same. By both the way, answer is same. Okay. So now, these are different method. Means you can use this and you can use this. Choice is yours. Now, next is a seventh part. In the seventh part, what is given? 17/20 is given. 17/20. One way is to divide this 17/20. But you will say 17 is less. It will not divisible by 20. So you can take the help of decimal. You can do division. Another way you can think about a number. When you will multiply this 20 by that number, so you will get, as a result, you cannot get 10 here. 10 nahi milega aapko, yes, because we have to multiply. So we after 20, we will try for the 100. So to make this 100, I'll multiply this by 5. So same I have to do with numerator. Yes, if I'm multiplying this by 5, so I have to do that with numerator also. So here will be 17 5s are 85 and 25s are 100. So what is our answer here? Simply put the decimal point, 0.85 1212. So I'll put point here. Now question number 4. In the question number 4, what we have to do? Like decimals. We have to convert into like decimals. This is very easy. Okay. This is very easy. You have done this in previous class also. Like decimals and unlike decimals. Like decimals are the decimals that is having equal number of the decimal places. Okay. And unlike decimals means that having different decimal, after the decimal point, different values. Okay. And like means after the decimal point, they are having same number of digits. So question number 4. What is given? 6.5. Another is 16.03. Third is 0.274. And 119.4. We have to convert this into like decimals. So we will write here like decimals. What you have to do for the like decimals? You have to count number of digits after the decimal point. In this, after decimal point, one digit, here is two digit, here is three, here is one. So maximum digits are three. So what we will do here? We will make three digits in all the numbers after decimal points. After decimal point, how? Suppose this is 6.5. So after decimal point, I need three digits. So you will put two zeros at the end. another is 16.030. At the end you will add one more zero. Third number that is already having three digits after the decimal point. Last one is 9, that is having only one digit after decimal, so you will put two more zeros. Okay, so by adding these zeros at the end, you can convert into the like decimals. Question number 7. Sixth question is arrange in ascending order. Okay, and one is fill ups. Question number 5, I think fill in the blanks. Okay, now the question number 7, arrange in descending. We have to arrange in descending. We have to arrange in descending order. So how we will do that? First is given, what is that? 7.4, 8.34, 74.4, 7.44, 0.74. Okay, so to arrange in ascending or descending in any order, first you will convert that number into like decimals. Okay, so first step is like decimals. Okay, so to convert into like decimals, we have to count number of digit after the decimal point. There is 1, there is 2, there is 1, there is 2, there is 2. So maximum digits are 2. So we will put 2 digits in all the numbers after the decimal point. Okay, by putting the 0 at the end. Okay, 74.40, next is 7.44, next is 0.74. okay, now by comparing the whole numbers and their decimal parts, we can write that into descending order. Descending order. So here this is 7.40, this is 8.34, 74.40, 7.44, 0.74. So we have to take first greatest number. Okay, this is 0, this is 7, 74, 8 and 7. So 74.40. Next number is 8.34. Next is 7.44, 7.40. So this will come first, 7.44, after that 7.40, after that 0.75. This is our descending order. Okay, now question number 8, express. In the question number 8 and 9, we have to express the numbers as a meter, kilometer, centimeter, like that. Means conversion is there between the units. So before that, we will do that formula. We will do that formula of the conversion. Means King Harry died, mother did cry much. This is our formula. This is the center. Yes, and if we are talking about the meter, we will write this. If we are talking about the liter, we will write here L. If we are talking about the grams, we will write here G. Yes, King Harry died, mother did cry much. Okay, you have all know this. Okay, so what is the criteria of this formula for conversion? If you are going on the right hand side, so number will be increased. Okay, if you are moving to the left hand side, then number will be decreased. And how that will be decrement? That will depend on the jumps. Means like this, if you are doing only one jump to the left side, so that means this the number that is given in millimeter, that will be divided by 10. Okay, and if you are going from kilometer to deca meter, what you will do? how many jump you have done? 2 jump. Yes. So that means you will divide that here will be multiplication. On the right hand side, you will multiply. I'm writing here, you will do multiplication. Okay. When you are going on the left, then we have to do division. So when you will convert any unit that is given in kilometer, you want to write that into deca. So you will just multiply by 100. Okay. So let's do the examples. Okay. I'm not rubbing this. Now the question number 8. Express 45 millimeter into centimeter, meter and kilometer. We are talking about the first formula. This is about the meter. So first, 45 millimeter is equal to what centimeter? Okay. So millimeter to centi, milli to centi. You are coming on the left side. So left में हम क्या करते हैं? Division. How many jump? Only one. So 45 upon 10. You can say 4.5 centimeter. Okay. Now 45 millimeter to meter. We have to go from millimeter to meter. Millimeter is here. 1, 2, 3. 3 jump we have to do. That means division on the left. So we will divide by 1000. 45 divided by 1000. It will be 0.045 meter. Okay. Now next is 45 millimeter, we have to convert this into kilometer. So how many jump? This is milli and this is kilo. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 45 will be divided by how many zero that will contain? 6. So it will be divided by 10 lakh. Okay. So now what is our answer? 0.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Our answer will be 0.00045 kilometer. Okay. Now the question number nine. It is given express as rupees. What is given? First given 9 rupees. We know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paisa. Yes? 100 paisa. So 9 rupees is equal to express as rupees. Okay. We have to express as a rupees. So here 9 rupees and 75 paisa is given. Okay. 75 paisa is given. Okay. So we know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. Yes. So if I will talk about the 1 paisa, so relation will be opposite. Or you can say 1 upon 100. Rupees is equal to 1 paisa. Yes, this is the relation between the rupees and the paisa. So here, this is already in rupees. We have to convert only this 75 paisa. So we will divide 75 by 100. So 9 rupees plus 75 upon 100 rupees. Okay. Why I have division here? Because in the 75 paisa, rupees will be less. So we will do here division by 100. Relationship is 1 and 100. So 9 rupees and this 75 paisa. So how we will write that in रुपीज, रुपीज में कैसे लिखेंगे 9.75, दिस इज रुपीज 9.75 रुपीज। ओके नेक्स्ट इज एक्सप्रेस इन किलोमीटर यूजिंग डेसिमल। व्हाट इज गिवन, आई हैव रिटन ओनली वन पार्ट, 284 मीटर। What we have to do in this, we have to convert this into kilometer. Okay, so this is in meter. Meter is here. We have to go to left. How many jump? 3 jump. And in the left division. Left में हम क्या करते हैं? Division. So that means 284. It will be divided by 1000 and this will be kilometer. So now we need our answer in decimal. 1 2 3 1 2 3, so 0.284 kilometer. Okay guys, solve this exercise, this is very easy. Okay, thank you.